Tonight on Times Over Schools Today, we will take a look at our upcoming weather.
And as we always have a look at some of the events from around the school district, Times River Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
You and I, we're like fireworks and symphonies exploding in the sky. With you, I'm alive. Like all the missing pieces of my heart, they finally collide. So stop time right here in the moonlight, 'cause I don't ever wanna close my eyes. Without you, I feel broke, like I'm half of a whole. Without you, I've got no hands to hold. Without you, I feel torn like a sail in a storm. Without you, I'm just a sad soul.
We'll do it all, everything. If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?
Welcome to Times River Schools Today. For Monday, March the 9th, I'm Oscar Anna.
And I am Mark Roma. Later tonight, we will check out our weather and we will see how one fundraiser is helping many people at High School East.
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary schools in our elementary happenings segment.
Starting off our elementary happenings, check in with your main office about upcoming shows.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm Steve Mister from TV21 with your random fact of the day. Did you know the original prototype for the Star Trek Enterprise spaceship was stolen from the creator Gene Roddenberry's unlocked van?
It's time to take a trip around the world in 60 seconds, road trip. Can you guess where we are today?
Thank you.
it's now time for us to take a look at the dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is hypaethral, meaning wholly or partly open to the sky, especially off a classical building having no roof. And now for today's sentence, the new building downtown is an amazing structure with a hypaethral.
Now we're going to be taking a short break, but coming up, we'll take a look at our intermediate happenings.
And we'll also take a look at your weather. So stick around, we'll be right back.
Crowded hallways are the loneliest places for outcasts and rebels, or anyone who just dares to be different. And you've been trying for so long to find out where your place is, but in their narrow minds, there's no room for anyone who dares to do something different. Oh, but listen for a minute. Trust the one who's been where you are, wishing all it was with sticks and stones. Those words cut deep, but they don't mean you're all alone, and you're not invisible.
Intermediate happenings at Intermediate East. Attention all 8th grade students. The first annual 8th grade Design the 8th Grade Send-Off T-Shirt contest is here. Do you like to design logos and draw? Would you like your idea to become a T-shirt that every 8th grade student will be wearing? Please attend our informational meeting on Monday, March 9th until late buses in C106.
Friday, March 13th, where there will be a dance from 6 to 8 for Intermediate East students. The theme is a sports dance. Wear your favorite team. Students can have their hands stamped on Friday, March 13th, during lunches. Cost is $5. Tickets will not be sold at the door. Reminder, we are still collecting coats for coat drive. Please drop them off in the box located in the main entrance hallway.
At Intermediate East, the TREE Club is sponsoring a pet supply drive for the Jersey Shore Animal Center. We will be collecting cat food, treats, toys, and supplies throughout the month of February. Please see the posted flyers around our school for specific products that they are looking for. All donations can be placed inside the collection bins in the main office or cafeteria.
It is now time for our environmental all tip of the day. Each day we are bringing a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
I'm Emily Lawson, and this is the environmental tip of the day. At work, double up, configure your office printer or copy machine so it prints on both sides of the page.
Every day on this show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day, so stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment.
A plane is struck in a tree after making an emergency landing in the backyard of a Florida home. Amazingly, no one was hurt. Two men and a dog were on board, but they all made it out. Uninjured, Rebera Casa reports.
In a tree in a neighborhood near the airport.
As I'm walking up to my house, I see people with ladders climbing over my fence, and I'm like, hey, what's going on? What are you guys doing? And they said a plane crashed in your backyard.
The plane came just feet away from crashing into Mickey's home. The pilot told the Okaloosa County Sheriff's Office it was an engine problem that forced an early landing. Mickey was out walking her dog at the time of the crash.
If I had gotten home from the walk any earlier, I would have been sitting right there watching the planes, because that's what I like to do on the weekends.
Mickey tells us on board was a father and son and their pet Labrador flying in from Kansas for a spring break trip. The sheriff's office reports all passengers came out without a scratch.
Thank goodness everybody was okay. No one was hurt. It was a miracle. It didn't hit the house, didn't hit anything other than tree limbs.
It is now time for another break coming up. Later in the show, we will take a look at your high school's happenings.
Time to our schools today. We'll be right back. Our high school happenings. Attention students and staff, the school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-hoo Snapples and waters for $1, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for your after school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Are you looking for something excitement? Do you want to help others? Why you don't become an EMT for the Eastover First Aid Squad? EMT applications can be picked up in the safety office. Just see Safety Officer Kenny or Officer Herbst in the main office. Let's stop in at High School East and take another look and amazing fundraiser.
Frillo with TR Schools Today, and we're sitting down with head football varsity coach Kyle Sandberg.
I became a teacher here because I had a lot of phys ed teachers that inspired me to be a teacher and help. I love activities, I love sports, and it allows me to be a coach as well.
Why ever pick? Team time and
enjoy what I do.
Green moves.
See? Varsity, not JV.
It's two jobs, really, in a sense. It's a lot, especially during the football season. It's a lot, but you know, phys ed comes first, and we do the best that we can to make it work. Classes in high school, you have your AP classes, you have your, you know, college prep, you have general, and in phys ed you have everyone's mix. So you kind of have to figure out a way to adapt to each kid, each kid's learning, where they understand phys ed. Some people don't like phys ed at all. And you got to figure out a way to motivate them to be productive, to enjoy their time in class. The connections and the bonds that we make and things that we teach in here are going to be life lessons, whether it's something we teach in health or just the ways to become a better person. You know, we play all these fun games and activities, but it's more than that. It's learning how to get at tough times and learning different set of skills that you might use in life. So. What I wanted to learn getting out of here is that they had a great time and that I'm always there for them when they leave here.
Kyle Sandberg is one interesting guy. Now we know what it takes to be in an AP Phys Ed class.
The Creative Writing and Art magazine of High School North is accepting creative writing and art submissions from all students and staff for the 2020 edition of Polaris Submissions. Can be turned into Mr. Dominio in BB7 or email to trpolaris@yahoo.com.
All Mariners college visits have been scheduled for this month. Meeting with representatives help you in your selection process. Come hear what the colleges you're interested in have to offer. You must see Mrs. Rose in the guidance to sign up in advance to attend. A list will be posted in your junior and senior English class rooms. And check the High School North website, TomsRiverSchools.com soon for a complete list each month.
Now let's take a look at what grinds our gears.
Hi everybody, I'm Edward Wolf, and this is what grinds my gears. When you're seconds away from picking up the phone and you miss it, and then you call right back and nobody picks up.
It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we'll take a look at a three-day forecast.
Tom's River Schools Today. We'll be right back.
Oh, well, now that they're up and gone, I
Starting off sports in Wisconsin, events went on as planned, including American Cup weekend. Reporter Casey Cronus was at the gymnastics competition and explained why concerns did not keep fans away.
The USA's most prestigious international gymnastics competition.
It's been amazing.
And it's the first time the American Cup has ever been held in Milwaukee.
Everything's been great.
On Saturday, gymnasts from more than a dozen countries, including China, Italy, and Germany, all took the floor at Pfizer Forum.
I was a little concerned if they were going to have it.
Fans say they were relieved the event went on as planned, even as various events around the country have been canceled over coronavirus concerns.
It hasn't kept us at home at all.
A spokeswoman with USA Gymnastics told Fox 6 News there were physicians on site and information was provided to all delegations on taking extra precautions to prevent the spread of viruses at the competition. USA Gymnastics confirms that Team Russia, initially set to compete, was the only team that did not attend, but did not specify why. In a statement to Fox 6, a spokesman with Pfizer Forum said in part, "We are closely monitoring the coronavirus situation, including coordinating with the NBA, which is consulting with the CDC and infectious disease specialists to provide up-to-date information."
There's threats out there everywhere, no matter what you do.
Not a concern for Don Kaiser, who says life is too short to live in fear.
Let's go out, live your life, have fun.
Let's now take a look at our three-day forecast for tomorrow. It will be cloudy with a high of 65 and a low of 44. For Wednesday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 56 and a low of 37. And finally, Thursday will be cloudy with a high of 56 and low of 45. Wrapping up tonight's show, Women's Helping Women.
Tonight's show, Helping Women, that was the theme Saturday when hundreds of volunteers showed up in Tuscan for Habitat for Humanity Woman Build Day. And it was an opportunity to give back, especially for some of the women volunteers who were gifted homes of their own. Mark Mingura reports.
These homes aren't given away for free. Along with the service hours, financial education classes, and saving for a down payment are required.
They go through this really rigorous process of financial education and home ownership classes, how to be a good neighbor, and how to be a community partner.
More than 300 volunteers showed up for this year's Women Build, including a few who have received their own homes over the years. Adriana, who got hers last year, was living with her parents before she got this opportunity.
It was a 10 by 10 room where it was my bed on one side and my boys' bunk beds on the other. So it was a small place for us to live. But now they have a room of their own. This is the first time that they've ever had a room of their own.
Habitat for Humanity works with new homeowners to make sure their mortgage is no more than 30% of their income, allowing people like Adriana to be able to take care of her family. Now, she's here to give back.
I called my mom crying. I called her crying because I was so excited that I finally did it. You know, I honestly didn't think I'd ever get a home for them, but I did.
According to the Habitat for Humanity's website, women are 35% more likely to live in poverty and occupy 60% of the lowest paying jobs in the nation.
You know, they come in with very little knowledge of budgeting, and eventually by the end of the process, after a year, they're experts, and they're really excited to be in their home.
It's more than a home. It's a hand up, not a hand out. That's why Adriana says this changed her life.
It gave me courage that I didn't even know I had. It gave me a sense of freedom. It's so many emotions that come to you when you do something like this.
Do you have a story you would like us to cover?
Or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it in inter-school mail, the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in TV21 throughout the day to catch this show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps it up for tonight's show. For Tom's River Schools Today, I'm Mark Roma.
And I'm Oscar Reno. Have a great night.